Now I am going to teach basic properties of magnets. In basic properties of magnet, first we are going to discuss about the magnetic dipole moment. Next, magnetic field. Next, types of magnet. Finally, magnetic flux. These are the basic properties of the magnet. The first, magnetic dipole moment. Here, what is mean by magnetic dipole moment? Magnetic dipole moment means it is defined as the product of magnetic pole strength and magnetic length. It is defined as the product of magnetic pole strength and magnetic length is called magnetic dipole moment. Here the magnetic dipole moment is noted by letter P suffix M. It is the vector quantity. It is the vector quantity. It is noted by the letter P M vector. Okay. So in a formula, here it is described as Pm vector is equal to the magnetic strength is noted by letter Q suffix M. The magnetic length is noted by letter D vector. So here Pm vector is equal to Qm and D. So to explain this, we consider one magnet. You noted this is a north pole of the magnet, this is a south pole of the magnet. Here this is the center of the magnet, that is called geometric strength of the geometric center of the magnet. Okay, that is not a letter O. Here this magnetic pole, north pole of the magnet, this is a south pole of the magnet. Here the north pole of the magnet is placed at a distance L from the center of the magnet. Same as here, the south pole of the magnet, it is placed at a distance L from the center of the magnet. Here you can note the distance between the north pole and the south pole of the magnet is have the value is 2L. It is noted by letter D. That is the distance between the north pole and the south pole of the magnet, that has the value is 2L. Okay students, that is called magnetic length. Here according to the geometry, here the length of the magnet, that is have the values, is always greater than the magnetic length. Okay, here the length of the magnet is always greater than the this values. The length of the magnet means that is the distance between the edge of the north pole and the edge of the south pole. That is not the length of the magnet. Here the length of the magnet is always greater than the magnetic length. Okay students. Okay, so the geometric length of the magnet is always greater than the magnetic length. So from this you understand that what is in the magnetic length. Magnetic length means that is the distance between the north pole and the south pole. Okay students, the value of D is substituted in this equation, we can write the magnetic dipole moment Pm is equal to Qm. What is in the D vector? D vector is equal to 2L. It is substituted in this equation, means we can write Pm is equal to Qm 2L. Here the SI unit of the magnetic dipole moment, that is equal to ampere meter square. The SI unit for the magnetic dipole moment, ampere meter square. Here the direction of the magnetic moment, the direction of the magnetic moment is always from south pole to north pole. South pole to north pole. The direction of the magnetic dipole moment is always directed from south pole to north pole. So next topic is magnetic field. So what is in the magnetic field? The magnetic field means the space around the magnet. Space around the magnet having magnetic field. The space around the magnet having magnetic field. To explain this, we consider one magnet. It is a south pole of the magnet, it is a north pole of the magnet. Now we take the another one magnetic material, or is magnet, the south pole, it is a north pole. Here this magnet is moves towards this magnet. When it is reached to the particular distance, here this north pole is attract the south pole. Already we know that. Okay. Why it is attracted means due to the magnetic field, it is attract the another magnet. From this we can explain what is in the magnetic field. The magnetic field at a point is defined as the force experienced by the bar magnet of unit pole strength. Okay, the force experienced by the bar magnet of unit pole strength is called magnetic field. Okay, so depend upon this unit pole, it is experienced a force. Due to the force, here this magnetic material is attracted by the magnet. So from this, what is the magnetic field? Magnetic field means the space around the magnet having the force. Okay, so that force experienced by the bar magnet of unit pole strength is called a magnetic field. Okay students, what is a magnetic field? Magnetic field means the force experienced by the bar magnet of unit pole strength is called a magnetic field. Here the magnetic field is noted by letter B vector. In equation it can be written as the force, this is a vector quantity, the force experienced by the unit pole strength. So we can write B vector is equal to F vector divided by Qm. For the magnetic field, already we know the force, it has a unit is Newton. The Qm, that is a magnetic pole strength, it has a unit is ampere meter. So here it can be written in divided part, means next step we can write ampere inverse meter inverse. So Newton, ampere inverse meter inverse, it is the unit for the magnetic field. Next, third property, types of magnet. Generally the magnets are classified into two types, that is natural magnet and artificial magnet. Artificial magnet. Here natural magnets means, here it is naturally we get the magnets from earth. Okay, so here the shape of the magnet is irregular. For the natural magnet, the shape of the magnet is irregular. The strength of the magnet is strength of the magnet is very weak. For the natural magnets, the example for the natural magnets, iron, cobalt and nickel, these are the example for the natural magnet. For the artificial magnet, here it is man-made magnet. Okay, it is made by the man. So here the shape and the size of the magnet is regular. The strength of the magnet means it has a desired strength and a shape. Okay, we can choose the strength and the shape of the magnet. Okay, so the strength is stronger than the natural magnets. Okay, students. So next one is here that shape, it is decided by the man. For the artificial magnet, it has a shape cylindrical or rectangular shape. Here, if the magnet it has a shape cylindrical or rectangular magnet, means that magnets are called bar magnet. Then the general properties of magnet. Here a freely suspended magnet, we take one magnet or magnetic needle. It is a freely suspended suspended means this freely suspended magnet is always point along north south direction. Okay, so you can take any one magnetic needle or magnet. It is freely suspended. So here is always directed towards north and south. Okay, so this is the first property of the magnet, general property. Next, when the magnet is placed in iron fillings, means the maximum iron fillings are attracted at the ends of the magnet. Like here, the maximum iron fillings are attracted at the poles of the magnet. Okay. So from this we conclude that here the attractive force is maximum near end of the bar magnet. The attractive force is maximum at ends of the magnet. Okay. That is a second point of the properties. Here, when the magnet is splitted into two pieces, this is north pole, it is the south pole of the magnet. Now it is broken and it is splitted into two pieces, means here the each pieces is behave as a magnet and it is also having the separate pole. Okay, students. So here when the magnet is broken into small pieces, means here that each pieces behave as a magnet and it has a separate pole, north pole, south pole, like this. Next property is two poles of magnet have pole strength equal one another. So like this, it is splitted into small pieces. Here the each poles have the same magnetic strength. Okay, so here the each pole of the magnet having same pole strength. Then last point of the general properties of the magnet, here already I explained to you the length of the bar magnet is called a geometrical length, and the length between the two poles is called a magnetic length. The magnetic length is always lesser than the geometrical length of the magnet. Geometrical length or length of the magnet, geometrical length. Okay, students. Here it has a ratio that is equal to pi divided by 6. Here pi divided by 6 means the ratio of the magnetic length to the geometrical length. Is equal to 5 divided by 6, it has the value is 0.833. It is one more question. Okay, so this is the ratio of the magnetic length to the geometrical length of the magnet. Now I am going to teach the next property, magnetic field lines. Here the magnetic field lines is always continuous curve. Is always continuous curve like this. Okay, it is one of the curved lines. Is always continuous curved lines. That is the first point. So the magnetic field lines are continuous curved lines, starts from north pole to south pole. Okay, we know that. Okay, so always here the lines are start from the north pole to south pole like this. North pole to south pole. So here the direction of the magnetic field lines, it is also given by drawing a tangent to the magnetic field lines at the point. So to detect the direction of the magnetic field, we consider the three points. Here we consider this is a point P, this is a point Q, this is a point R. To indicate the direction, we are drawing the tangent. So we draw the tangent to the point P means it has a tangent is like this. At a point Q, we draw the tangent is like this. At a point R, we draw the tangent means here this tangent is given the direction of the magnetic field lines. So the direction of the magnetic field lines at a point on the curve is known by drawing the tangent to the magnetic field lines. So the direction of the magnetic field at a point on the curve is known by drawing the tangent to the magnetic field. So next point is magnetic field lines are never intersect. Okay, so you can see in the diagram. Okay, the magnetic field lines never intersect each other. Last point, the degree of closeness of the field determine the relative strength of the magnetic field. Here the degree of closeness, the degree of closeness of the magnetic field lines is determined the relative strength of the pole of the magnet.